This is a poster from the turn of the century, the Lick Observatory lecture series in California, Mount Hamilton, California. We're going to limit back it so that we can put it back together and give it a new lease on life.
How are you exactly going to fix this?
Well, this poster, because of its age, has become very dry and brittle, and it's being eaten away by acids. Paper has acid. Commercial papers produced since the 1840s have acid that deteriorate the paper. So the paper's become very dry and brittle, and as you can see, because of its condition, it cannot be displayed. So the paper is very brittle and dry, and we're going to linen back it so that we can arrest the acids from deteriorating the paper. In the cases of these edges, where you have paper missing, after it's linen backed, we can go in and replace that and make it appear more like it did when it was first printed. Linen backing helps the paper to survive longer. We're going to preserve a piece of history. We put an acid buffer into the ink paste.
So you apply two coats?
Yeah, we do one coat now, then I put we paste on the canvas, and then I come back and I put more on here because it has to absorb the wheat paste. And then the poster will be mounted to this paper, and they'll all dry together. Use a brush to apply the wheat paste to this poster because the paper is much more delicate, and the roller could accidentally rip the poster because it's so delicate and dry. I have not applied water to this poster because this paper is very thin and it has a tendency to absorb very quickly.
Something happens to the paper when that liquid touches it.
Canvas, like paper, is a weave. It's a tight weave, and when you add the wheat paste to it, it absorbs and it makes the weave expand. When it dries, it'll contract again, and that's why it becomes very tight and flat after several days of drying. These posters have historical significance because they show early mass advertising. Posters were a powerful way of communicating a message on a national scale. I will take paper, period vintage paper of this time period, the 1890s. I will find paper that matches this poster, or I will put as close as I can find and then adjust the color later to match the poster. But we'll fill in these holes here, like this hole, with paper after it's been linen backed and after it dries. I've been doing this kind of color restoration and paper restoration on posters for about 20 years. All these techniques that we use are archival. We add the longevity of the poster.